Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making slow cooker corned beef. I have a few other recipes for corned beef in Betty's Kitchen that you might want to look at, but I thought you might want one that is just really easy because you put it in a crock pot or a slow cooker and just let it do its thing and it's done and delicious. A corned beef is a roast that has been soaked in water and salt and some pickling spices. So this is called a corned beef brisket. But brisket is a tougher piece of meat, but since it's soaked like this, all of these ingredients in here serve to soften it and make it tender. So you can use what is generally a tougher piece of meat if it is corned. The weight over here, we can see it's about 5 pounds, and it does call it a corned beef brisket. And this is just a store brand, so you don't have to have any particular kind. I'm going to do it in my crock pot, and you'll notice that I have put some aluminum foil in here. Quite often I will do that. You may do this, but it's totally optional. When I put the juices and the corned beef uncooked in here, then I want to enclose it the best I can before putting the lid on the crock pot. That keeps all the condensation in and keeps the corned beef cooking in its own juice. And I don't want to water it down. A typical method of making corned beef would be to bake it in the oven and put about 1 inch of water in, along with the pickling spices. Or you could put it in water on the stove and just cook it that way. It's very accepted, but I think that reduces the strength of the pickling sauce and it waters it down too much. So what we need to do is get this open, and we will be placing all these juices in there, and we'll put the brisket in there and we'll set it to high, and it's going to take about 4 to 6 hours. So I'll be checking it all along and I'll let you know how long it takes. But we'll have a nice, tender corned beef that we can let rest a bit and then put on a platter and slice, or slice first probably, and then put it on a serving platter. But these juices are intended to go in. And I think there might be a spice packet in here. If there is, it will show up. I think I'll just let all of this out and we'll see what we have. It's just a little messy here. And I'm going to take my hands and get down under it and make sure I don't have a package of spices that I'm cooking in a package. There's the package. And then we'll just sprinkle this, which is optional. You do not have to use these spices. And you just want to loosely put that down over the top. So we're putting the lid on. I've already set it to high. So we're in for a little bit of wait, and I'll probably check it after 3 hours, although I don't expect it will be done. If you have any questions about whether it's done, it should be fork tender, or you can actually measure the temperature if you have a probe that you can put in it. It needs to be 160 degrees. Now, this is what I'm making for my family for St. Patrick's Day, and it's an entree that I think you will enjoy, and there are things that you can do with the leftover corned beef. We'll discuss some of those later. I want to catch you up on the corned beef brisket. I checked it an hour ago and it was not done, but I checked it after the 4 hour period that I thought it probably would be done, and with the meat thermometer it did register around 160, a little bit over that in places, depending on how thick it was. You'll see that there's a lot of liquid still in here in the aluminum foil, so that held a lot of liquid up close to the brisket, and that's why it's going to be so tender. But at this point, once I've removed it, I want to tint it with aluminum foil. And that just means cover it loosely. You don't have to have a tight seal or anything. And then just let it sit for about 20 minutes. Our brisket has rested for about 20 minutes, so I'm going to slice it and put it on a nice platter. And I've just started a little bit because I lined it up so I could see the grain, which runs in this direction, so I'm going to cut against the grain, and that gives the nicest, tenderest pieces. So I'm just using this kind of knife. Use a knife of your preference for slicing. I've sliced our corned beef brisket and put it on a platter, and I decided to decorate it by putting cabbage leaves around it. This is uncooked cabbage, and I just cut them if they needed to be more slender so that they would fit in an oval around the corned beef. Cabbage is a natural accompaniment to corned beef, and I think the colors go well together. So that's the way we're serving it. And as far as tasting it, I'm going to take a fork and try to show you that it is very tender. And if I go in at some point and try to get some out, let me just bring this to the edge a little bit and cut it. And I'll take a bite. We'll see what it's like. It is very tender, juicy, salty, not overly. It tastes really good, came out really well. It's just perfect. And it's an easy way to do it, and also it's almost guaranteed that it will come out well, and that it will come out tender. It won't be dried out from the oven or won't be burned or anything like that. So I hope you enjoy this demonstration and maybe you can use it.